Right now then, DD Groups, about a year ago it was, they're back. They've got another new single, it's called Kisses for Charity. Have a look at this. Finding out when that one was out, I was asking. It's good.
Thank you.
I liked the one that you had out last year as well. Really, really catchy. Just, I wouldn't sing it because I wouldn't offend you. It would not be nice to do that.
Right.
So what's it like second time around? Is it good fun?
It is good fun, yeah. I mean, we're able to sort of all enjoy it a bit more now, you know, and sort of not take it too seriously. I mean, obviously in the early days, it sort of consumed every waking hour, but it's more of a sort of pleasure these days.
Yeah, I bet it is. And it's been doing really, really well, because that's the last single did really well, the album did really well.
Yeah.
And I'm sure this one will too.
We hope so.
I'm sure it will, I'm sure. But it must be really good, though, you know, to sort of come back like that.
It
and
is.
Know that the music is still there and people are still loving it.
It is good, but you always go through that sort of panic period whenever you make a record and then you get ready to release it, because there's so many channels and obstacles you have to go through to actually get it into the charts, so it's always a bit nerve-wracking.
Yeah, you forget about that. I mean, we just think, oh, you make a single and it suddenly becomes number one or whatever it does, but I suppose there's a lot more, it's a business, isn't it, and there's a lot more to it.
Also, you know, I mean, Radio 1 don't give us any airplay. They won't play anybody from the 80s.
Crazy.
So, you know, you've got all these sort of, luckily now there's lots of other radio stations like Radio 2 and Capital and Heart that will play you, but...
I'm listening to Radio 2 now, that's...
Well, they actually broke Culture Club, you know.
I know.
D.D. David Hamilton, God bless him. He actually was the first person to ever play a Culture Club record, and I've always loved him since.
It's all right now. It's all right now. It's Radio 2. We don't mind.
We always thought Radio 2 was cool, though, you see, right from the beginning.
So everybody's caught up with you, so they have.
Yeah.
So it's been good fun. You've enjoyed it. It's great. And anything, when you're sort of, have you learned anything, do you think, now from the second round? Are you more sort of in control of things than you were before?
To a certain degree. I mean, you know, you like to think that you're in charge, but obviously there's so many other people sort of running around doing things on your behalf. But I think the main thing I've learned is that, you know, the pop life is a charmed life, and, you know, sometimes it's over before it started, so you've got to squeeze every last drop of pleasure and enjoyment out of it.
I think that's a great philosophy. I mean, I was reading a piece that you wrote in the Express, wasn't it?
Yeah.
The Express yesterday, and it was exactly that.
Yeah.
You were saying just enjoy it, because, you know...
I was talking about Ricky Martin, because, you know, apparently he's a bit of a diva. But, I mean, that sort of stuff is funny, because it makes you more interested in the artist, makes you want to know more about them. I mean, people like Madonna, for example, because she's such a diva, it sort of keeps you interested. You want to know what she's doing next, you know. And I'm as bad as the next person.
Yeah, oh yeah. Well,
I love
know,
a bit of gossip.
Yeah, absolutely, so do I.
Yeah, Pummy Magazine.
I know, it makes you want to go down, that's for sure. But as well as doing the music, you have carved out a career as a writer. I mean, you do a lot of writing.
Yeah, I'll write for The Express on Sunday.
Good.
I've done
it's
it for about 2 years now.
Yeah.
And I really enjoy it. I enjoy it particularly because I left school with no qualifications, so to be writing for a national newspaper is a bit of an achievement.
For you. Absolutely.
I'm sure it annoys my headmaster. I hope he's watching.
I think you probably did annoy your headmaster.
I did actually. Actually, after I left school and when I started Culture Club, there was a sort of debate in the Times because he did an interview and discussed my school record.
Oh, yeah.
So there was this big hoo-ha about that. But yeah, I left school and they said, you'll never be anything. So it's quite nice to be.
Oh, it must be very nice.
It is nice.
Oh,
yeah.
It must be very, very nice indeed. And you know, we're watching all that couture stuff. I think you go to all these shows, don't you?
I was in Paris, yeah. I was doing the music for the Versace show, and it's great fun. I mean, you know, you just got to take it as a bit of fun, because a lot of people do take it very seriously and get really upset if they're not in the front row, and you hear people storming out, and it's very funny. But if you're sort of not involved in it,
if you can take a step out
and you're watching it as a sort of people watcher, it's great. Yeah. I mean, I was at Versace, Madonna was there, Prince, or the artist formerly known as Prince Squiggle, whatever he's called, he was there.
Actually, out and about, I didn't think Squiggle came out. I thought Squiggle just stayed in his compound.
No, he was there with his new wife, and he was wearing a lovely glittery outfit. He looked like Lisa Minnelli with a beard.
Oh, gee. That conjures up a lovely image.
And I met him as well.
Did he speak?
He said he liked my earrings. That was the extent of the conversation.
I think that's a really deep relationship you've got there with him.
And I think we've got a future. I think a duet is on the cards.
He doesn't say very much at all. But you, I mean, look at your hats. They're brilliant in all of your style. I mean, do you take, when you get up in the morning, what do you say to yourself? How do I feel today and what shall
what's
I wear?
What's clean? What's clean? What did I wear the other day on TV? It comes a bit, you know, it gets a bit difficult if you're doing a lot of TV. yeah. it gets a bit difficult. If you're going to a lot of parties and you're wearing the same hat, you know, it's, you've got to sort of decide.
That's very true.
Put things in mothballs for a few weeks and then bring them out again.
Exactly. But like I was saying, you know, you carved out the career doing the writing, also DJing.
Yeah.
You've got a great career there.
Well, that's my sort of weekend job.
Yeah.
And, you know, I really enjoy doing that. I go all over the country. Do a lot of work in Scotland.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, it's good fun up there. Yeah. They like raving up there.
Just a bit.
They're mad for it.
One or two.
In fact, the last tour that we did, the best gig was Scotland. They were just so nutty. They literally sang every song. I wouldn't have had to bother singing. I could have just stood there all night with the mic out. I mean, they really got involved. It was good fun.
Do you like performing this time round better than when it first all happened? Are you better?
I think we're all better musicians, yeah. Mm. And I think, I mean, in the early days, I hated touring. I hated it. Because you're sort of thrown into it, you know, and it's like it was something I'd never done before.
Sure.
And you lose your voice, you know, you get ill because you're doing so much travelling. But I think as you get older, you get more stamina. Mm. And you sort of know what to do when you go on stage. And plus, people know all the songs now.
Yeah, exactly.
So there's that familiarity, which really helps, you know, doing a live gig. It's great.
Well, it's a joy to see you as always. Good luck with the single.
Thank you.
Great to see you, George. Thank you very much indeed. And we have to end on a very sad note.